we do one thing? Why don't we just read the translation first so we know what you're singing? Sometimes it's easier. Sometimes you read the Bengali wordings, you don't know what you're singing on. So let us first read the translation, understand it, then we stream. So, oh brothers, chant, Hari, chant, Hari, chant, Hari. Lord Goranga, Lord Nityananda have brought the holy name. And in brackets, sing our unhappiness. So that also will come in brackets. Then we are singing. So they saw our unhappiness and they are bringing the holy names. Now, except for the holy name, there is no other treasure for the soul. So now we are seeking treasure. So this is the treasure. So by the influence of the holy name, even Jagai Madai became pure. So they are both greatly sinful persons. So that is the background. So I pass my life uselessly bound by Maya, always saying I and mine, wandering here and there, under the control of mundane desires, where shall I go next? There's no end to worldly desires. Does this show our picture to us? Something like this. You're always wanting more and more different things for enjoyment, right? So this is our plight. Looking at our plight, the lordships have come down. Oh brothers, chant Hari while looking directly in the face of material desire. You see them? You see the material desire? Right? On its face and you chant Hari. Just go away. Freedom from mundane hankerings is the platforms of actual happiness. Giving up all desire for mundane enjoyment and liberation, I chant the holy names of the Supreme Lord. Having become pure and situated in transcendence, I dance in ecstasy. Enjoy, enjoy. I dance in ecstasy. This is the real enjoyment due to the power and divine qualities of the holy name. And thus I obtain all these results. Having given up all endeavors for insignificant material results, Bhaktivinoda says, I conquer all impediments to the pure chanting of the holy name, having given up all offenses to the holy name. So offenses will come later.